Hey guys, so today's focus is going to be all about completing the lion mane. So I'm going to carry on doing the underlayering with the marker pen so that it looks like this, and then we can start adding the detailed work over the top with pencils. Okay, so I'm coming in now with the Goldenrod PN69 Prismacolor Premier marker. I'm now going to come in with the Sepia PM62 and create softer lines for all the dark areas on the mane. Now that I've done the underlayering of the markers, I'm going to spray all the marker pen areas with a fixative workable mat by Mikador. And once that's dry, I can go over it with pencils. Okay, so using my Prismacolor and my Polychromos swatches, I'm going to find a few colors and then I'm going to use them to do the detailing on the ear. So I've got the reference over here. I'm going to compare the swatches to this picture here and try and find the closest colors, and then that is what I will be using. So for patrons, if you go and have a look at a post I made in August of 2016, you will see a post where I have the swatches and how to complete them and where to download the templates. I'm using my Polychromos Brown Ochre number 182, and I'm just going to start working some hairy little pieces within and around the ear, just to make things, the texture look softer and more hairier, and just extend on the underlayering with the marker pens. I'm not worried about not getting any white or very light highlights in. I'm going to use a fine line white paint marker to get the extra sort of hairy overlaying bits. Later on we'll do that with a paint marker. So if the underlayers end up getting a little too dark and I can't get the lighter colors over the top, that is okay. So I'm just going to continue on as much as I can with this color, the Brown Ochre 182. Okay, I'm gonna come in with a Prismacolor Black, PC935. Just do the blackest areas and sort of the darkest shadows, and then we can come in with a few other colors. Okay, now I'm going to use the Goldenrod PC1034 and just shade in some areas that are a little more golden. Now I want to come in with the Burnt Umber PC941 and just work on a little more of the detailing in this section of the ear. Okay, now I want to use some of the white PC938. Just sort of grab some of the highlighted sections. So the solvent I'm using is the Zested solvent, the Zested pencil blend. And that's just going to make the black look a little more matte and not as waxy. And it's also going to take away that crayon look. Okay, now I'm going to use my Uniposco white paint marker, the 0.7 mm, and I'm gonna use this to add all those sort of hairs that are going over the top. So many of them are going in random directions. If the highlights end up being too light, that's okay, we can add color over the top later to sort of blend them in a bit more. So they might pop out a bit extreme at the moment, but that is okay. And I'm gonna come in with the sand PC940 and also just sort of extend over some of the darker bits to give it more depth so it doesn't just look like black random patches. So kind of extending on the highlights that we added with a white paint marker. Over some of the white paint marker highlights just so that it's not as white. It's got a nice subtle yellowish color to it, which should make it blend in a bit better. Yeah, that ear is already looking nice and soft and realistic, and then as we work the areas around it, it's really going to blend in. So it's going to look really great once we work on the section next to the face and the ear and sort of bring it all together, and it will start looking a little more realistic. So I'm going to start working on the areas around the ear. I think I will actually work on this area where it's connecting the side of the face. So again, we will start off with the Polychromos Pencil Brown Ochre number 182, and we'll work the little fine hairs in this section. Thank you. I'm coming in with Sepia PC948 just to establish where the darkest shadow is under this bit so I don't miss it later. Okay, now we'll continue on with the brown ochre 182. Okay, now I want to use the Espresso PC1099 and extend the darker pieces into the lighter pieces. Okay, I'm going to continue working on this section of the face, maybe a bit more on the top of the mane, and then sort of create a smoother transition between the mane and the face. So using my Sepia PC948, I just want to create a little bit of a shadow over here. Not a shadow, just a darker value. I just want to add a bit more to this section. Now I'm going to use the sand PC940 and just sort of blend those areas that are in between the really light marker pens. I just want to cover that with this color, and that'll just give it a better transition. Now to really make a blend, I'm going to use my zested solvent and use a flat brush. It's a number 0. It's a little bit of a flatter brush. Okay, now I'm going to use my Uniposco 0.7mm white paint marker, and I'm going to go and do all the random little hairs pretty much all over this top section. And then yes, it will come out very white and very highlighted, but then after it dries, we can add a little bit of color over the top to make it blend in a bit better. But that's at least gonna help us because the hairs are too straight, they're all just too uniform and consistent.